Hey everyone, this is Eric with Upton Bass, and it's getting to be about that time of year where the heat's clicking on, the humidity is dropping, and it's time to start getting concerned about keeping your double bass healthy. We recommend keeping a relative humidity of about 40%. I think 40% is realistic. It's not so much of a challenge that you're constantly putting water into your humidifier. You're not using up tons of electricity to keep it there. 40%, it's realistic. So it's good for the instrument too, because wood doesn't like sudden changes, big drastic changes. So if you're keeping your instrument around 55% humidity, and then you go out to a gig where it drops down to 30 or 35%, that's a pretty big loss. Whereas if you're keeping your instrument around 40%, you get to the gig and it's 30 or 35%, it's not as big of a loss, it's not as extreme. So the instrument's a lot more forgiving in those types of situations. You get two ways that you can monitor it. The way that on the extreme end is a sponge. I'm sure you do the dishes at night, and you'll notice this time of year when you come back to the sink in the morning, the sponge is either completely dried out or significantly dry. That's the telltale. That's the sign that it's time to start running some sort of a humidification. In the summer months, I'll do the dishes at night, wake up in the morning, and the sponge is just as wet as it was when I went to bed. So that's kind of the extreme. The other way is to get one of these little digital hygrometers. They're good. Most of them will tell you the temperature. They'll tell you the percentage of humidity in the room. Right now it's registering 43% in this room. Just jumped up to 44 because I'm talking, so a little humidity on it. But you can pick these up Walmart, Target, wherever, usually about 15, 25 bucks tops. You can get them on Amazon.com as well. There's tons of these. As far as the style of humidifier that we recommend, we like wicking style humidifiers. They're harder to find because they're not what you would typically get for a person. People, like if you're sick, get a cold, flu, or you just want to keep your bedroom moist, typically there's the evaporative styles or the ionizing or the warm mist styles. Those put an excessive amount of moisture into the air, and I think that's one of the reasons why when you wake up, there's you get a lot of water accumulation on your windows. That's, in my opinion, a sign that you're over-humidifying. There's too much water in the air. So to put a realistic amount of water in the air, enough so that the instrument can absorb it without it condensating and getting on the windows and getting on the varnish of the instrument, a wicking style. Wicking style has paper wicks. It draws the water up into the wick. Fans are blowing past it, and it's letting the air take a natural amount. A wicking style, it doesn't have to be this big. This is for a big room here in the showroom. If you're keeping your instrument at home in a large room, you might want to get something like this. They're a couple hundred bucks. But a lot of times you get the small, 2, 2.5, 3 gallon size humidifiers. Those wicking style ones, run around anywhere from 30, 40, maybe 50 bucks or so. So I'm going to put a link in this video down below here where you can click to get to our website. I also recommend dampits. I did a video on those that tell a little bit how to properly use dampits. But I'm going to put a link below here linking to the dampit page because you can get a little bit more information about proper humidification, how to take care of your instrument. And I got a few links on that page too, sending you out to Amazon to show you a few humidifiers that we recommend. So, all right, thanks everyone. Have a good night. Take care of your instrument.